all this talk of food, I've been hungry too. So, point seven, balance sheet. Looking at the gearing, I guess, from the first point of view, their debt levels, their drawn debt levels are slightly down on last year. Again, it's on the base of better earnings, and they've paid out some debt. Although their facilities, when you look at the annual report, haven't changed, hence 107 million of debt, the amount of money they've drawn on those facilities has actually dropped slightly. So overall, their debt position doesn't look any different, but if you dig a little bit further, they've actually put that back slightly. Their interest cover is about 5 times their earnings, which is good, I guess. That's probably not, it's not as great as others, but it's okay. The thing, and you'll find this out this afternoon as well, and I'll focus on it quite closely, is the intangible assets of Sandgroup. So those intangible assets, that quota system, that's their primary asset. So, and that's where they leverage all of their income from. And that there is highly, how do I describe it, influenced by government decisions. A change in the quota management system, a change in, I guess, people's attitudes, change in the ability for Sanford to catch a particular type of fish because it's been overfished recreationally, or has quite a large effect. So that intangible asset is very valuable to them, and it's very difficult to get a hold of that from another company.